But today we're quickly going to make this file in Embird using third-party fonts along with the fonts that you can purchase directly from Embird. When I was working with third-party fonts, I found that all of the tutorials show you how to work with third-party fonts only in Embird Editor and not in Studio. Sometimes you may just want to make some changes to the design. So here we go. So first you start off in Embird Editor. You're of course going to choose the correct size for your embroidery hoop. Then you're going to go to Insert in Ready-Made Alphabet Text. Once you select the ready-made alphabet text, you'll hit the plus button and locate the font that you would like to use. Okay, I would like to use the size 2 Sherlock font. So I'm just going to hit OK. And Embird is going to populate this font. Now that the font is populated into the system, I just have to select all of the letters. Now that all the letters are selected, I'm going to go over to Properties and just make sure that all of the letters are there as I had typed them in, because sometimes they do come up wrong. Now I'm going to go over to Layout and make sure that all of my letters are somewhat aligned properly and have the correct spacing. I usually just add a little bit more of spacing between each letter and then make final adjustments at a later time. So for this design, I would like to print out Atlanta on a sweatshirt. So I want to change the baseline from just straight across to a circle. So I'm going to go over to where it says baseline and then select circle. But you can also select other things like wave or spiral, or there's just all sorts of things you can do. And now I want to adjust the start point so that it is centered. And of course you can make adjustments to all of the different letters by pulling at the different points there. But I'm just going to leave it the same. I'm just doing that so you can get a basic idea of how it is. And you can also adjust the spacing between letters at those points there that are between each letter. Now that all the adjustments have been made, I'm just going to select OK. Now, I would like to do some different things with this text. I would like to add a font in that is a font that is directly from Embird that I have in Embird Studio. And I also would like to add a shape to this. So I'm going to left click and go down to Edit in Embird Studio. And this will drag the file over into Embird Studio so that we can edit it. Once this file has been dragged into Embird Studio, I can now add whatever text I'd like to add to it, as well as any types of designs or more motifs that I would like to create. If you wanted to, you could really even change up the text and change the font itself to make it look different. But for this tutorial, I'm just going to add in some text direct from Embird Studio, and then I am going to add a shape to it just to display to you how you can make changes to the file. Once that is done, you'll simply want to go up to Design and Compile in Embird Editor, and that's going to drag the entire file back into Embird Editor, and from there you will just simply save the file as whatever file type that your embroidery machine accepts. That way you can just stitch out the file on your embroidery machine. I really do hope that this information is helpful to you. And if you haven't already, please do subscribe and hit that notification bell, as it does help me to be able to create more content for you like this. I hope you really enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe to receive more sewing related content.